How you doing, Real Motivation? Terrence McKinney here with a new video. Today's video is called The Streets Don't Love Us. The Streets Don't Love Us is something I had to learn the hard way. So today I'm gonna break it down and explain to you why the streets don't love you. Number one, the money is a mirage. The money is what attracts most of us to the streets. We're attracted to the big houses, the nice cars, the fancy clothes, the jewelry, the beautiful women that come from having all of that, the respect, the power, being able to do what you want, when you want, that's a powerful feeling. But I'm gonna be the first one to tell you, it's all a mirage. Because the minute the feds come, or the SWAT kicking your door, they're gonna take everything. They're gonna take any cash they can find. They're gonna take any car that you may have. They're gonna seize any business that you have. They're gonna seize any property you have. They're gonna seize anything that they think came from drug money. And you might be like, okay, I'm gonna outsmart them. I'm gonna put this in my cousin's name. I'm gonna put this in my grandmother's name. All you're gonna do is get that other person caught up. And that other person gonna be put in a position when they forced to tell on you, because they're gonna be in the courtroom and it's gonna be either you or them. And they ain't used to living that lifestyle that you used to. So guess what? They gonna tell on you. And even if the feds or the SWAT team don't find all your money, say you got a hid in the backyard or you got a hid in the walls, guess what? You still gotta bond out and you still gotta fight a case. And it ain't nobody who been in trouble or had to get a lawyer gonna ever tell you that a lawyer gonna be cheap. Or you can wish your freedom in a public defender's hands and don't pay him nothing and see what that get you. Or you can do a paid lawyer. And a paid lawyer is gonna cost some money. And then even if you make it that far and you got a paid lawyer and you still got money, and now it's time for you to go sentencing and it's time for you to turn yourself in and you're gonna trust somebody on the outside world with your money. That could be your baby mama, that can be your wife, that can be your best friend, that can be whoever you think you're gonna trust with that money. But if you leave a lump sum of money with anybody, and you gone 3 to 5 years or 5 to 7 years or 2 to 4 years, and you think that money gonna be there when you get out, you a fool. That money almost surely will be spent on something. It's hard for a person on the outside world who still live a life that had that type of money and experience a rough time in their life and not spend that money. So the money is a mirage means everything that you work for and everything that you hustle for in the streets can vanish in one night. And so the money may look good and you may think you have it, but you would lose it just as fast as you gained it. Number two, the lifestyle isn't good. So you think it's cool to always have to look over your shoulder, always have to watch your back, always have to check the rearview mirror, make sure you ain't being followed home. Always got to circle your house twice to make sure ain't nobody waiting on you on the next street over, or ain't nobody waiting on you at the end of the street. You think it's cool to have a gun everywhere you go? You think it's cool to have to carry a gun to the grocery store? You think it's cool to have a gun on you when you're doing stuff with your kids? Do you think it's cool that you can't expose your kids and your family to certain people? You can't take them to certain places? You really don't want to be seen with them in public because you don't want people noticing who your kids is. Ain't none of that cool. The streets is like boxing. You got to protect yourself at all times. If somebody do something to you, you got to do something back. Ain't nothing cool about that. Ain't nothing cool about having to hurt somebody or harm somebody because they did something to you. And if you don't do something back, then stuff will keep happening to you. The lifestyle in the streets isn't cool. Number three. The outcome. Ain't no happy endings in the streets. There's two places the streets lead to. You're either gonna be in the jail cell or the cemetery. Death or prison. Them the only options. And ain't either one of them cool. What's cool about doing the 3 to 5? What's cool about doing the 5 to 10? What's cool about doing 25 to life? What's cool about having to wake up in a cell with another grown man or another grown woman for the next 5 years of your life? What's cool about you being locked up and somebody on the outside that you don't know parenting your kids for the next 5 to 10 years? What's cool about your brother, your father, your sister, your cousin, or somebody else have to step up and fill the role that you should be doing? What's cool about being in jail working for 10 cents a day? What's cool about getting a $20 check from the state every month? What's cool about all your freedom and all your rights being stripped from you because you can't change your lifestyle? The only place worse than jail is death. And what's cool about being dead? Nothing. Because once you die, ain't no changing nothing. Ain't no coming back. You may have just ruined somebody else's life. You might have just ruined your son's life. You might have just ruined your daughter's life because you couldn't change your ways in the streets. So listen to me and listen to these three things. The money is a mirage. The lifestyle isn't cool. And the outcome, the streets don't love you.